Hello, welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another video. And in today's video, we are going to be showing you how to enable and configure your entity hider. So let's get started. So first of all, with all of our plugins, we need to go ahead and go onto our plugin section. Then if we just go ahead and type in entity, it should then pop up, and it does indeed. And like always, for the purpose of this video, we will just go ahead and favorite it. And then if we go ahead and cancel the search terms, it should now appear near the top of our list, and it does indeed. So now we've done all that, we're now ready to go into the configuration settings of this entity hider plugin. So now let's just go ahead and click on edit plugin configuration. And as you guys can see, there is a decent amount of options that you can all mess around with. Let's just run down a quick example. For example, if we want to play RuneScape like it is an abandoned ghost town, and if we just scroll out a little bit, as you guys can see, we have everybody here in the Grand Exchange. But if we want to get rid of everybody, and including the NPCs and pretty much everything that is around us, then we can do. Let's just go ahead and just do that. So to do that, we will need to click on the enable thing at the top. So if we go ahead and enable the plugin, that is the biggest part done. We've now got rid of all of the other players in the game. So if we just go ahead and just enable everything, and then we can literally just get rid of everything in the game. We can also get rid of yourself if you really wanted to. Hide local player, that gets rid of you. If we go and hide NPCs, it'll get rid of everybody in the game, including all the NPCs. Then we can go ahead and just keep on going through all this. If we want to get rid of people's pets, then we can do. Now if we close the configuration tab, we are now left in RuneScape by ourselves pretty much. It's basically just like a barren ghost town now. There's nobody here. That is pretty much how you configure the entity hider. A good example for entity hider would be if you are playing Wintertop. Because that game is in such a small area and there is a lot of people doing it, it can get a little bit congested. And the two options you'd want to turn on if that was the case is to hide others and to hide other pets. That way, it will get rid of pretty much everybody in Wintertop. This could help with frame drops, and also will help with you knowing where you are, because Wintertop is a very, very small place, especially for the amount of people that are in there. So having an entity hider on is a very good way to solve that issue. Let's go ahead and just turn entity hider back off, because I personally don't use it when I'm actually playing the game. I only use it in certain scenarios. But like I said, you could just go through all these settings and just play around with it, and just if you enjoy playing by yourself without anybody else in the world, go ahead and do it. But that is pretty much gonna conclude this video. So I hope this video was somewhat helpful for you. Let me know in the comment section down below what plugins you'd like me to cover next. But like I said, I hope you guys have all enjoyed, and if you have enjoyed, please like, comment, subscribe. It really will help the channel grow. I've been Ben, and I will see you in the next Runelite guide. Goodbye.
If you guys are looking around for your newest game, make sure to check out CDKeys.com, because they have the cheapest CD keys available on the internet for pretty much every game, even new releases. I'll drop a link down below if you guys want to check them out.